What's up, girl? What's up, sweetheart? Yeah, you sleeping? Good girl. Good girl. Hey, everybody, it's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training, and we're a couple minutes late. Tonight, we're starting 1 hour late, actually, because we're in a different time zone. We also are in, met some folks for dinner in Fredericksburg, Texas. This is the lovely Linda Gellman right there.
Hello, everyone.
Okay, it's fantastic. Maui here. All right. Oh, hey, hi, Maui. How are you? Let me get my camera set up before we get right to the Q&A. Let me just get all this stuff set up. Let me get my chatterbox on.
Hey, JBZ.
There we go. There's that. Kira. Eric, thank you so much. Thank you. That's great. Well, we just got to log on. We got some, slow internet. Slow internet. All right. Okay. Yeah. Thanks a lot for that, that conversation we had today too about Kira. Thank you. I really appreciate it. I'm really looking forward to it. All right. So let's start the show. A lot of nonsense happening over on my chatterbox. Okay. We'll start the show. Hey, everyone. My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. That's Solid Canine Training. And I'm a balanced dog trainer in Providence, Rhode Island. And we've got a wonderful board and train facility in Providence, Rhode Island. I've got 9 awesome staff there that allow me to actually travel the world doing seminars. So we specialize in behavior modification, aggression rehab. Obviously, there's a lot of wonderful things we do with puppies and your average family dogs, but it allows me to tour the world and do seminars. So what you can do is, that was a great seminar in Dallas. Yeah, a lot of great stuff's coming out of the Dallas seminar. There's over 20 hours of video, 1,000 photos. That's just on my camera systems. So a lot of great stuff. You go to rvdogtrainer.com. You can see my seminar dates. I'll actually be in Australia for a couple of dates. I've got a Taiwan date that I've not even announced yet. We just launched Philadelphia, and we actually are announcing our 2016 Dallas and Austin dates, which will be a year from now. So we're actually booking them now because they sold out. The chatterbox is just for me. So chatterbox is just for me. One of these days, hey, Philadelphia, just announced a seminar there. So chatterbox is just for me. That's just something I use on my system. So, and I'll explain how I do my periscopes. And I can do a how to do a periscope. Hey, Sean from Arizona, how are you? All right, let's get right into the show. I know a lot of people have been looking forward to this. Every Monday and Wednesday, historically at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, what happens is that's the time when folks can actually ask their dog training questions. The reason is I get over 12, sometimes 20 emails a day asking for help, and I can't do that, and I apologize, but there's just no way I can do that. So, Linda, let's get right into the questions. Just push it right out of the way, Linda.
I don't know what it is.
It's a food bag. Okay?
Okay.
All right. That's if you fine. Can't put your question here, then what you want to do is you want to probably do a Skype session with me or do small questions at a time. Try out by doing small questions at a time. All right? Try that. All right. Don't yawn, Linda, please. Okay. Let's go. What do we got?
There's no questions yet.
Yes, there is. Somebody asked a question about a vibrate button.
No, they said if you use the vibrate button, it's like using a clicker.
No. Remote collar is not like a clicker. It's two different things. Vibrate button, I personally don't use the vibrate button on a remote collar. People are talking about remote collars, and I don't use the vibrate button. I'm absolutely not against using the vibrate button, but I don't use it. I use just stim. So I use momentary stim or continuous stim. I use it to whisper. I use it to shout. 90% of the time, it's at a working lower level, but I absolutely use it to correct dogs. So if you're uncomfortable with the concept of correcting a dog, then let me introduce you to a big, huge, 100-pound, one-year-old white dog that was at my seminar this past weekend, and you're more than welcome to train that dog with a positive-only approach, and you will have a biting machine. So now is a great time to get all your questions in. Great time to get the calm on command. Awesome question. So calm on command is this. Calm on command is actually more of a philosophy than a command. So calm on command. So this is what we do with calm on command. So here's a great example. See this dog right there? Oops, no, you can't because the camera's facing the wrong way. See that right there? Okay, that's girl. And she's one of my traveling dogs, all right? So she's one of my traveling dogs. And what I would do is she's calm on command. So what you want to do is you want to work on duration things. Duration place, duration down, right? Girl's a working dog. She's a high drive dog from Czechoslovakia, and she's high drive. And right now, if we went outside, she would run. She would play ball for 2 hours. She would swim in the ocean. She would do bite work for a ton of times. But right now, she can't. So I tell her place, she goes there, and it looks like she's zoned out. That's what calm on command is. How did I achieve calm on command? By having really strict yes and no. Really strict yes and no. So if you don't know my philosophy on dog training, it's really, really simple. If you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. You know what you can do? Let's give me some hearts. I answer questions for hearts. So heart. Give me some hearts by tapping your screen. There's a little character in the corner. Click on that character. Share me on Facebook. Share me on Twitter. Share me with your Periscope friends. Also follow me. And you might also want to turn on your alerts. This is dog training. Let's simplify it. All right. Dog training is this. Yes. No. Do this. Don't do that. Now let's go to motivation. How do I get you to do this? How do I get you not to do that? That is dog training in a nutshell. So, for instance, one of the questions was, do you use the remote collar to stop eating poop? That was a question. I believe I saw the question. Yep. So, yes, this is what I do. I consider eating poop an act of God correction. So, act of God correction is this, remote collar on the dog. So, all my act of God corrections are unspoken. I don't use words. I don't even need to be present. So, what I would do is I would go in my house and I would look out the window and I would wait for my dog to go eat poop. The dog would have its remote collar on. I would have it set up to the highest setting the remote collar had. And then I would hit, as soon as that dog goes to eat poop, I would hold the continuous button for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Now, I prefer the dog has been conditioned on the remote collar. Means it understands where the remote collar. I don't like people that do this, like, hey, what's my remote collar, and put it on the dog and just go to the highest correction. I'm not a fan of that. I don't recommend it. I actually don't do that. You should not enjoy that. You should get zero pleasure from that. It's not pretty. You shouldn't feel like, look what I did. I taught that dog. It's more of, sorry, I have to make the act of eating poop suck. It has to be miserable. Then what do I, when it, then what, it's almost like rattlesnake aversion training. So now the dog goes up to poop and goes, I'm not going to take part in that. And that's what I'm looking for. That's what I'm looking for. Dogs can get all kinds of diseases from eating poop. All kinds of diseases. Okay. So yes, to answer your question, what else do we got?
What's your best trick for doing an auto sit when stopping during a walk?
Okay. I don't teach tricks. So there's no tricks that I do. I don't do tricks at all. So I just do training. So what I do is this. The beginning, I will shape it. So at the beginning, I come to a stop, a little bit of leash pressure up, a little bit of 2 fingers on either side of the spine towards the back of the dog, down, almost like a lever system, like that. And then as soon as the dog sits, you release the up, you release the down. And then you do that every time. Now, once the dog starts giving you that, what you do is if the dog doesn't do it, you do leash, just a leash pressure up. And then if the dog still doesn't do it, you would give it a quick pop. And then the dog would be doing it. Now, what I do, then what I would do is do a bunch in a row. So walk 10 feet, stop, boom, sit. Walk 10 feet, stop, boom, sit. So just do it over and over and over. The problem is that most people aren't doing enough drills. They're not doing enough drills in training. Remember, training is drills. It's a series of drills. So it's a series of drills. That's what we're looking for. So anybody that's in sports, anybody that's in the military, anybody that's ever done, you know, any sort of task training, right? Repetitive training, even a professional pool player, ping pong player, golf player, I mean, drill after drill after drill after drill after drill. Okay. So it's a non-thinking thing. All right.
What do you do about a dog that has severe issues with other dogs in public, but no aggression?
Okay, define severe issues, but I'll assume maybe it's leash reactivity, barking, lunging. This is what I want you to do. Unleash? Okay, it's most likely unleash, right? Okay.
The question might be in there.
Okay, so really if it's on leash, what I want you to do is teach your dog a proper heel. Heal is this. This is my philosophy on heal. It's work at my side, at my pace. All right. Okay. At my side, at my pace. Got it? No sniffing, no marking, no lunging, no barking. I turn right, you turn right. I turn left, you turn left. I stop, you automatically sit. That's it. Now, I like and I excel at training remote collar healing. Remote collar healing. So I like my dogs to be a little bit behind me. I like my dogs to be more in follow mode. The reason why I like my dogs to be in follow mode is this. Three-car caravan. Rhode Island to New York. The first car. Well, first of all, let's just make it easy. Who's got the most stress? The first car, right? They got to follow the GPS. They got to pay attention to the road conditions. They have to pay attention to the signs. They got to pay attention to the exits. They might have to communicate with the people second and third, right? The first car is the most stressful. All my military people that have done that, come on, right? Who's got the most stress? The guy in the front, right? Your point man. So 2 and 3 are followers, a lot less stressful. I want my dog to be in follow mode, not leader mode. Put your dog into follow mode. You will immediately get rid of 95% of your leash reactivity. All right. Next question.
I'm missing questions here. What do you do about a dog that does dominance play with other dogs?
Okay, what do you do with a dog that does dominance play? So now, in my own pack, so I've got 9 dogs now. So I've got 9 dogs. In my own pack, I absolutely allow play rougher than I would anywhere else because I've got intense pack structure where my pack knows exactly their role and they know I run the show and then everybody is underneath me. With out in public, say I hate dog parks, please don't go to a dog park, but if you go to a dog park, I don't like dogs playing rough with other dogs because it could spur a dog fight. So what I do is this. You can use a quick stim of the remote, but you can also use your dressage whip. So if you see us in the socialization yard with the dressage whips, when dogs get too heightened up, we give them a quick swat on the butt. Now, our socialization sessions are more like a cocktail party type, not a European soccer match, okay? I want everybody just to walk around the room and say, hi, my name is Bob. Hi, my name is Bob. Hi, my name is Bob, all right? I don't want everybody to walk around the room saying, what the fuck you looking at? Bam! That's not what it is. That's what it is. All right, next question. Hold on. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. All right, and go to my website. You'll see what I do. I've got actually a working kennel in Providence, Rhode Island, and an awesome staff of 9. I keep saying that because they are awesome, and I love my staff. That's where my personal assistant is, as well as my head trainer. And we've got 3 people on the training staff, and they rock it. They are just incredible there, which allows me to travel the world training dogs, doing seminars. I just came off my Dallas seminar. Woo! 35 people, 17 dogs. I was getting face bite attempts and I was dancing with dogs and oh yeah. But guess what though? There's a photo on my Facebook page of 15 dogs in downstays at 9 a.m. on day 2. Linda.
Something is bothering me.
Okay, that's the seatbelt.
You can't even move.
Okay. Okay.
Hey, Julie.
9 a.m. on day 2. All these dogs on day 1 lunging, pulling, barking, aggressing, jumping, barking. On day 2, 9 a.m., before we even like finished or even started day 2, on the ground calm. Everybody took a turn weaving in and out of them. Dog reactive dogs, dog aggressive dogs, human aggressive dogs, dog that didn't even know how to do it down the day before. Okay? Think about this concept. Guys, it's not magic. It's not a miracle. Anybody can do this stuff. I'm a simple dog trainer. Okay. I'm a simple dog trainer. One of my dogs, Kira, is out in Ohio getting some awesome training. She's going for bomb detection and bite work. That's hard training. Me? Down your dog. Tell your dog not to bark. That's easy. Go to a placemat. Walk next to me. Don't jump. That's easy stuff. Okay, next.
Hold on.
Dog park people would freak if they saw you use the dressage whip. Dirty looks. Yeah, that's why you don't go to dog parks. That's why I won't go to dog parks. Never, never. I will never go to dog park.
Okay. I'd like to see your spinning and peeing in crate protocol.
Spinning? What? Spinning and peeing?
In crate protocol.
Well, spinning is easy. Use a remote collar to interrupt it, stop it. So spinning, and you need that. Peeing in the crate, first of all, check for UTI. Check for UTI. So if you got a dog that pees in the crate, I would go medical first. If it's not medical, this is what I would do. Monitor its water. So monitor its water. And then also get yourself an Excel spreadsheet. Make an Excel spreadsheet. All right. Days of the week, times of the day. So days of the week across the top, times of the day up and down. All right. And then what I want you to do is track. Inside peeing by mistake and outside. And outside peeing. All right. Track it. There is a schedule to the inside peeing. Now, what you can do is this. If you can't fix the inside peeing, this is what you do. Do you know how they have those things, that the crates that shrink? You can make them smaller this way. You can make them smaller this way, right? You know what you do? You make them smaller this way. Yep, your dog has to crawl into the crate. It sounds mean, I know, but a dog that can't stand up in a crate, guess what else it probably can't do? Piss. All right? Piss. This is not forever. Okay, it's not forever. I know this might sound mean, but you know what mean is? A dog in a pound. Do you know what mean is? 5 million dogs a year. People give up dogs. They surrender their family pet for pissing in a crate. People surrender their dogs for jumping up on counters. People surrender their dog for the easiest things. Resource guarding. It takes me 3 seconds to stop resource guarding. It's a really simple thing. Anyway, what's next?
Do you recommend the use of slip leads?
We use slip leads to transport dogs from point A to point B. I think it's really, really hard to train a dog on a slip lead. I can, big deal. I'm a freaking dog trainer. I can train your dog with a slip lead and a food pouch. That's all I need. Big deal. I'm a dog trainer. I've trained over 3,000 dogs. That's what I do for a living. But my clients, no. I want my clients to have tools. I want them to have tools. I love remote collars. I love prong collars. I want to empower my clients. But those tools just facilitate the conversation. The tool doesn't do the training. Training does the training. The tool helps communicate it. You still have to understand drive. You still have to understand motivation. You still have to understand your timing. So it's not just the tool. All right, what else do we got?
What is the very first collar you would start with? Do you recommend?
Depends on the dog. Fearful dogs, remote. Most dogs on a prong. Okay. Someone asked me, am I picking up Kira? Yep, I'm picking up Kira in my RV. You know, an Ohio meetup would be super. I don't know if I can do an Ohio meetup. I don't exactly know where I'm going. Yes, I sell websites through my website. Go to my website. Yep. Active God, dog correction. How do you act towards the dog if the dog runs and goes to hide? Let it go hide. Let it go hide. I don't care. But I do active God for counter surfing. I actually have a video. So I did an active God for counter surfing at my seminar. So we took a piece of pizza. We put it up on a counter. The dog was on a prong collar or in a remote collar. All right. And I pretended I wasn't paying attention. I had the leash. I walked over to the counter. I didn't like go jump, 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 jump. That would be mean. That's how you lose trust. And had the remote. And I'm like, doo, 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 doo. Dog went up to jump on the piece of pizza. High level correction. Bop. Dog screamed. Moved back. I knew it was Scream. I told everybody it was Scream. I'm fully transparent. I'm fully transparent in all my protocols. I don't hide any of my work. So guess what? Guess what the dog did? I couldn't even get it near the counter. So I put the dog into avoidance. I'm okay with that. Dogs don't belong around kitchen counters anyway. And what did the dog do? Dog was fine. Why? Because what did I do? Nothing. You're nothing. Next question.
My dog is over one and it's still toothy with hands and feet.
Okay. So your dog is over one. So what you've never corrected your dog for doing it. For not doing it. So over 1 year old, correct. Correct. How? Remote collar, dressage whip. Thanks, Danny. Thanks. I moisturized it today. I used that Aussie 3-minute moisturizer. I did that.
I'm pretty sure Danny was talking to me.
How do you know? Why? It's not about you. Why do you always assume it's about you? Thanks, Danny. Fist bump, buddy. Bam. All right. What's next?
Dog is always vocal when meeting new dogs. It's a friendly sort of vocal, but it's annoying.
So shut it down. Correct it. Correct it.
Looking super silky.
Okay. So listen, anytime you want to stop a bad behavior, you've got to eliminate it. All right? You got to eliminate it. So correct it. Leash pop. No. Remote pop. No. Because it's an energy issue. It's energy issues. It's energy issues. Okay, what else?
My dog is hyper around people. How do I get the dog to be calm?
Your dog is hyper around people. This is what I would have your dog do. Number one, this is what I would have your dog do. Have your dog in a command for starters. Place, down, or heel. Don't let anybody meet the people. Don't let your dog meet anybody. I want you to train your dog to exist around humans, to ignore humans. That's what I want them to do. Your dog to do. All right. That's what I want. So your dog will not become unsocialized all of a sudden. So girl, I don't let people pet my dogs. But if I all of a sudden let people pet my dogs after a year, they're not going to attack them. Because they're friendly dogs, right? If I lived in France and only spoke French, back to the United States, and I was walking down the street, and as soon as the first conversation I had in the U.S., somebody walked up to me and says, "What time is it, sir?" I would say, 3:00. I wouldn't speak in French. The dog won't all of a sudden stop being social. Right now, let's get your dog to be existing around people. Existing around people. Okay. Your dog feels that the world revolves around your dog. I personally like dogs that ignore people. I strive to have my dogs ignore people. Why? I want to be everything to my dog. Everything. It's just me and the dog. That's it. Remember, being with your dog, existing with your dog is praise. Eye contact is praise. Physical touch is praise. Verbal affirmation is praise. Food reward is praise. Play is praise. Toys are praise. Going places is praise. Okay? Unless you're taking your dog to be put down like 5 million other dogs do a year, going there ain't freaking praise. What's next?
My dog reacts to a surprise when we're on the trail. The dog's off leash, and if people are approaching, the dog gets startled.
Okay, what does the dog do?
Didn't say.
Okay, and you know what the dog does. But if you've got a dog that's doing anything dangerous off leash in an open area with people around, your dog should not be off leash. Or your dog should have the most incredible recall where it turns on a dime that as soon as you see somebody, you can say here, and that dog spins around and comes back. Hey, did everybody see my cow recall training last week? I recalled 50 cows. I said, there's a bunch of cows in a pasture, and I go here, and all these cows came to me. Check it out. It's on Facebook. I recalled 50 cows. No lie.
Yeah. How come I didn't hear about
that? Check my Facebook page.
But I'm right here talking to you all the time. We're like right next to each other all the time.
I know, but...
But you still didn't tell me about the cows.
You go to my Facebook page.
But...
You just heard it now? What, would you want to hear things before everybody else does? Okay. Great.
Okay.
Tomorrow I'm going to take a big dump. You know, before everybody else does.
But I already know that stuff.
Okay.
Because every morning you take a dump.
Okay. What else?
We're missing them.
Okay. So how do you do recall? Recall, I do. I've got a video on that. Recall is, I've got a video on that, right? So on recall training, I do remote collar recall. I remote collar train every dog. So I'm a remote collar dog trainer, right? So this is how I started with. So this is how I started with. I started with, ready? Leash, prong, food, remote. Low level. Coming back to me is the most awesome thing in the world. So the only thing you do for 2 weeks is we do recall stuff for food and the remotes. And I've got a demo. Oh, I've got it on video. I've got three videos on recall on my YouTube channel. Go to my YouTube channel. Okay, everybody go to Solid Canine Training, solidcaninetraining.com, upper right hand corner. I've got 1,000 videos for free. Click on the YouTube video. YouTube link, look up in my YouTube channel, search for recall training. Watch a video, all right? You thought it was a bull? Yeah, that first, the black one could have been a bull, but guess what? They kissed. Yep.
Who, girl?
Girl and the bull. Yeah, yeah.
Of course they did.
Yeah. In fact, I got that bull's phone number next Saturday night. Yeah, they're going out to dinner. Chris Ruth Steakhouse. Yep. You won't recognize the animal, all right? What's next?
How do I keep the dog to keep focus when he sees another dog or a squirrel?
Okay. So you're going to do that eventually with a remote collar. What I want you to do now is food protocols, food focus protocols. So I've got a video on food focus protocols.
Hold on a second. Just so you know, the dog bolts, the dog runs away.
Oh, that dog needs to be on a long line. Okay. A long line, prong collar, remote collar. And that dog's not off leash. You're going to teach that dog an intense, intense recall. And you're also going to do focus work. Focus work, I do focus work with its daily food. So for 3 weeks, everything I do is for 3 weeks to train these new behaviors. So I do three weeks. Hey, Mr. Six Man, fist bump, bam. Okay, so 3 weeks. So what you're going to do is you're going to do focus work. You can use clicker. You can do a clicker if you want to, but I want to do eventually remote. So the way I train dogs, the finished product is this. Dog looks away, tap, tap on the remote. So the dog goes, boom. And then you can click if you wanted to. That's a lot of apparatus. Okay. I got a video on it. What else?
9-month-old collie is biting hands, but we just did another question just like
that. Yeah, we just 9-month-old cow. You've got to correct it. It shouldn't be biting hands, but that's most likely a relationship issue. What I would ask you is this: why is your dog biting your hand? So let's talk about a couple of different things. Not enough structure in your dog's life. Possibly not enough exercise, but okay, it is a given that dog. Hey, whoa, egg. Emmeline, no. You put up a picture, Emmeline. No eggheads. Give me a picture of you. Give me a picture of your dog. Give me a picture of you flipping me off. Come on, please. We want pictures of you. I want to know who we're talking to. We don't do it like that. No hidden secrets on this show. We're a big family. You agree, right?
I guess.
We don't have to agree, right? So. What is the question?
I have a lot of questions. Okay. How do you stop resource guarding?
Well, resource guarding, you stop resource guarding with a remote collar. 3 seconds makes your life suck. So, sorry, can't do it. So let's use a toy. Now let's use food. Food resource guarding. This is what I do with food resource guarding. Take the food bowl, put it down, let the dog eat from it. You just tell the dog, out, hit the, oh, shoot. Sorry, girl. Nope, girl. Nope. When I say out to her, she thinks something's wrong. Nope. Nine pots. Girl. Sorry. I'm going to have to start spelling that. O-U-T. Whenever I say that word around her, she thinks whatever she's just doing now is, that's how powerful the word is. Just to give you guys a heads up. Every time I say that word on my radio show, she literally goes, up. Oh, I'm not supposed to be doing what I'm doing. So you say O-U-T. And you hit the remote on a high level, the dog backs away. Now, this is not what I want the dog to do. This is not an out. So this is my food. Okay, if I resource guarded my espresso, okay, which I would never do. Actually, I just lied to you. Yes, I would. This is what I would do. So watch. So now you're going to do this. Ready? You say out window. Ready?
Out. Out. Hey.
I don't believe you. You have to go up higher. Mm. Okay. That was out. Now, this is not out, though. This. Shoot. I just said the word again. I'm sorry. Okay. Said the word again. Sorry, girl. Girl, I'm sorry, okay?
Everybody loves how I'm busting you.
Okay,
tonight.
So, and that this is OUT. This is it, like this. I don't care about the coffee. We just messed her up, girl pots. Okay. So, and then you give the food bowl back to the dog and you say eat or take it or break. The dog's eating again. You say the word again, O-U-T, boom. How long did I take to train her to train me? I ain't freaking untrainable, man. I'm a training failure.
Uncle Mike's on.
Hey, Uncle Mike. I'm a training failure. There ain't no training this, man. What do you want me to do? All right. So that's what I want you to do. Now, you do it again. By the third time you say O-U-T, you don't even use the remote anymore. That's how you fix resource guarding. All these dogs being killed in shelters for resource guarding, you know that fake plastic can? You know that plastic can that they put in the food bowl? If the dog growls at it, they kill the dog the next day. Please, let's clarify this. Dogs are killed within 24 hours of biting that plastic can. I can fix that in 3 seconds. I do all the time. I do it in public, in a public seminar setting where people are videotaping my work. I let all my seminars are videotaped. This weekend, my brother's not funny at all. My brother's not funny. He's type A. His humor is not even dry. Okay?
We're not coming to the Western States before we're done.
Happy wife, happy life. Damn right. It's all about her. It's all about her.
Oh, P.S. I probably won't be in Ellenton. Whoever asked that.
Yes, you will.
I'm going to Universal Studios that weekend.
Oh,
with the kids.
Oh, all right.
Oh, I'm going to do a seminar on husband training. All right.
Okay, great. Yes, I will. Oh, my God, Raquel, number one, listen, don't pay attention. You are so sexy. Oh, shit. It's incredible. Oh, my God. I would come to Brazil just to do it one-on-one. Stop. I'm trying to bond with my clients here.
They're offensive.
I'm trying to bond with her. I'm waiting for a question.
Do you want me to throw my wine in your face? Oh, okay. Dog is scared of the remote and freezes.
Ah.
Won't even respond to treats.
Okay. Well, you shouldn't be using treats anyway. You should be using the dog's daily food. This is what I want you to do. I want the equipment on. It's called the training equipment. Wake up in the morning, equipment goes on. Go to bed at night, equipment goes off. What I want you to do is the only way that dog eats is through training. Your levels might have been too high. The only way that dog eating, if it doesn't take food today, oh well, this afternoon, oh well. What I want you to do is then again tomorrow and then again the next day. Your dog will eventually eat. Okay? Yep. For my dogs for bite, yeah, I use pucking. Sounds like fucking with a P. Pucking.
Are you talking about when you're playing tough?
Yeah. So
Mr. Six is
yeah, pucking. So I use out and then pucking. But you can also use break. Sorry, girl. Yeah, she just bit my leg. Shit.
She did not.
Yeah, she did.
I asked one earlier about dogs that go into panic mode in public. No aggression, just escape.
Okay, mode. So your dog gets into escape mode. Okay, so what you want to do with that is, so fear-based behavior, believe it or not, this blows people's minds. But I want you to know it has been a game changer for us. A game changer. for working with fearful, anxious dogs. Remote cower training. Remote cower training. Okay? I know you're nervous. I know you're afraid. I know you're scared of the world. I got it. But this is what we're going to do. We're going to train you baseline behavior, baseline obedience. Heel, recall, sit, down, place, yield to me. Okay? Yield to me. All right? Now what I want you to do is this. You're nervous. You want to flee. I got to make fleeing a little bit uncomfortable to a lot uncomfortable. So how do you turn the discomfort off? Get closer to Jeff. Ooh, God, I love it. I love being, this is my wife's mantra, by the way, too. I love being next to Jeff. I love being next to Jeff. Okay, so that's what you do. That's what you do. It works. It works. Then you start doing confidence building stuff because you can't use food then, you know? So everybody's sort of like, oh no, you should use food. Nervous, fearful dog ain't taking food. All right. They won't take food. They won't take food. All right. What's next?
E-collar trained dog barks on place if startled. Even high level correction doesn't stop it.
How long is it? If it keeps barking. Oh, you're getting a, don't, please do not get a 6 week old puppy. Please do not get a 6 week old puppy. Wait till 8 weeks. Do not get a 6 week old puppy. It's way too early. Yep. I know she won't take food in panic mode. No dog does. You shouldn't use food in panic mode. Yeah.
Can the reaction to sudden presence of people improve?
Oh, no, no, that's not acceptable. No. So, yeah, 8 weeks minimum. 8 weeks minimum. So what I would do is, not allow that dog to charge. Your dog charges at me, I assure you, recall will be the last thing we're concerned about. Okay? So anytime a dog charges at me, I neutralize the threat. I know it sounds mean, oh, whatever, dog lover, blah, 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 whatever. Okay? You get charged by enough dogs, you get bitten by enough dogs, you get your pack attacked by enough dogs. Sorry, I'm old school. I neutralize the threat. All right? This is the way it is. It's the way of the world. My dogs have been attacked way too many times or attempted to be attacked by friendly dogs. So if your dog is charging, that's the problem right there. Stop the charging. Stop the charging. So what do? Put them on a line. And as soon as he starts to charge, correct high. Correct high. Yep. A lot of my answers are high-level corrections. If you're brand new to my show, you're like, all this guy does is correct dogs high. Let's just clarify something. No, I don't. 90% of the work I do, a human cannot even feel the remote. Hey, Shaq, how are you?
I was just going to say, hey, Shaq.
Shaq, man, you must be killing it because I don't see you around anymore. So 90% of the work I do are at levels that a human cannot feel. Why do I get so many questions about where the answer is high level? No trainers will talk about it, and no trainers would ever talk about it in a public arena like I do, ever. Nobody will be this transparent. This is not ego. It's fact. I'm not seeing a lot of hearts coming up. You guys not liking the show?
I don't like that. It's the second comment that I don't like.
Oh, Manitash, yeah. That's really too bad. That's really too bad. You've got to be such a dick. You know what I mean? It's really too bad, Mantash. You got to be such an asshole. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, you could put a remote collar on me and you could stim because you know what though, but I think you're just being a little bit silly and you really don't understand the concepts of dog behavior and you also don't live in my arena. So wherever you're located, you can send me a private email. And what I'll do is next time I've got a dog with some serious problems, I'll pay for you to fly to me. So I'll pay for airfare. I will pay for a hotel and I will also pay you $5,000 and I will film you rehabbing one of the dogs that I work with. Okay. And you have to fully off leash train that dog. And you're not allowed to use an aversive. You can only use positive training. You can use no aversives at all. Okay. All right. And I will put it in writing, and I will actually have my lawyer send it to your lawyer, and I will put the money in escrow. And this is not a joke. I am 100% serious. Okay. Airfare, hotel, and whatever you make a week, I'll pay you for your week's wages. You fully off-leash train that dog. And this will be a dog that is leash reactive, either dog or human aggressive. Okay. And I want him fully off-leash trained. And at the end of it, I want him to be safe around my children and around my dogs. And then you get the money. Okay. And I will film it. Okay. Right. Say what you want, but you don't play in my arena. You don't. You're not in my arena. You have no idea what I do. You don't. All you've got is a big mouth and fingers on a keyboard. And you can call me a dick, call me an asshole, leave me a bad Yelp review, leave me a bad Facebook review. Do you really think I care? I could care less about you. You are this small. Okay. Next question.
You go, girl. Recommend the use of one remote for two dogs?
Yes, I do. Yes. But remember, you can only use either a momentary or continuous. You have to take your pick. So either both dogs are on momentary, both dogs are on continuous, or else you have your fingers get really, really busy. Really, really busy. All right? Really, really busy. So you can get a 302. So from e-collar technologies, you can get a 302. 302, 402, 802. So a 302 is good. For 90% of the dogs, you would need a 302. All right? Cool. Yeah, let's see all the hearts.
I don't know why. Yeah. I see them. They're coming in.
Yeah, this is probably why.
Oh, look, you got them.
Yeah, but a couple. Remember how you saw people? Oh, the 302 is great. Great.
Border Collie dominates overzealous pups. How do I stop that?
Ooh, so what I would do is your dog is being the sheriff. So your dog is being the sheriff. So what's happening is your dog is being a sheriff, and you can really freak out the dog. You can really freak out the dogs. You can really freak out the dogs. So what I want you to do is, I'm not seeing any questions at all. Huh. I'm not getting any questions. Yeah. So what I would do is I would use a little dressage whip. I would use a dressage whip. And then what I would do with the dressage whip is I would just give him a little swat on the butt. Because your dog's not going to do that. He'll get into fights. He'll get into fights. Yeah. Next question.
Chihuahua keeps getting hurt jumping off the beds and couches.
Don't let the dog go up on the beds or couches. So don't let the dog go up in the beds and couches. Or you can do, if you want your dog on the beds and couches, if you like are, if, and if your dog's not aggressive, does not have separation anxiety, does not have resource guarding, put a little step, those little ramps or little step stools. Yeah. Remote collars aren't that expensive. $199 for the e-collar technology. So I bet you can find the money somewhere, right? A lot of things. You can use just a prong collar. You can use a long line. People have been training dogs for thousands of years without a remote collar. You don't have to have a remote collar. I just love them. I just love remote collars. So what causes aggression? What causes aggression usually is an owner not saying no. That's the number one factor in aggression, in my opinion.
Hold on. Wendell Burke, ask your question again. Sometimes I can't get all of them down in time.
Yeah. So for some reason, I'm not seeing the questions. And Linda is. So, well, the mini educator from Amazon for $150. That's great. Wow.
What should I do if my dog will not let me or any female correct him?
If you've got a dog that you can't correct, you've got a major relationship problem. Major relationship problem. So what I would do is I would go to Nothing in Life is Free. Start creating. Any questions? So Nothing in Life is Free. I would crate your dog at night. I would crate your dog during the day. I would also, what I would also do is.
We did this question. Dog tries to dominate overzealous puppies. Yeah. Didn't we?
Yep.
You just
swap them on the butt with a little bit of a dressage whip. All right. Okay. And whoever made that comment about the remote collar to the hearts, you can also do that to me, but I could probably tip you on that one because I like that kind of stuff. Right. but not a female. So it's not, I don't know if it's a female thing, but it could be an energy thing. It could be an energy thing. So I'm not saying female energy is weaker. So I'm not saying female energy is weaker, because a lot of times male energy is weaker. I've got many male female relationships where the male energy is weaker. I also have a lot of female female relationships where one of the females is weaker. So dogs respond to energy. Dogs respond to energy. Okay. All right, next.
If I haven't answered your question yet, it's coming. Do you not use food if the dog is too excited, even if you are calm?
No, you can use, you know, you can use food. Food tends to excite dogs, but it all depends on what it's for. You know, it all depends on what it's for. You don't need to use food for training. You know, I didn't for eight years. I didn't use food. 9 years. I didn't use food for training at all. You don't have to use food. There's other ways to reward the dog, but I would start working that dog on calmness. I would start working that dog on calmness. You know, that's what I would start doing. So calmness, like duration. Stop, don't be in the dog. So, what's next?
How do I stop the puppy in a crate in the car from whining?
Remote collar. Yep. You see, a remote collar is not a shocking zapping device. A remote collar, so here, give me an example. So Linda, start whining. What whine? So all a remote collar is, it's a very low level. It would literally match this. It really is. So people keep in mind that remote collars, working level of a remote collar is less pressure than a flat buckle collar, going like this. How many times have we seen dogs pulling their owners down the street on a chest harness, flat buckle collar, or martingale? How many people have seen that? Over and over and over again. That dog is being corrected, punished, being used in aversive with way more than I ever do. Yes, I did tug. Yes, I do. I do pucking, Mr. Six. Pucking. Fucking with a. Hey, stop, you know, Mr. Six, man, you got to stop, you know, call of duty is happening. What else? Stop asking me damn questions, Mr. Six, if you're not going to wait around for the answers.
There's some questions I'm missing. How do you scroll down in this chatterbox?
Scroll up or down. Tuning in with Solid Canine Training, go to my website, Solid Canine Training. These are sort of like speed rounds. I can't get into depth about all these answers because these are some pretty complicated things, but there's more to it than that. So I'm just giving you basic ideas on how to do it. I also do private Skype visits. No, we start dogs at 14 weeks old. Puckin, that's just a word for bite that I use. P-U-C-K-I-N. This is the word I use for bite. It's my bite word.
Do you like the EZ-900 with multiple?
I've never used it, but I've heard good things. All right.
Off-leash trained dog not responsive to high e-collar correction with deer, I think it said.
What model are you using? What model are you using?
They asked if you recommend the Boss.
The Boss, yeah. Go to the 800. Yep. Go to the 800. Also, catch the dog. Make sure your fit is proper. Make sure you can use a dog trod 1900. You can use a dog trod 1900 or the Boss 800. So make sure you've got a proper fit. Make sure it's nice and snug. If it's a thick fur dog, make sure you're using the proper thing. All right? Proper thing. Okay. Place cuts are from petcat.com.
T300, it was working. What does that
mean? ET300, that's the e-collar technologies.
What causes aggression?
Well, I answered that already. What causes aggression? The number one reason that we've got aggression issues is, this. Owners are not saying no. That is the number one reason why we have aggression, because at the moment the dog shows any sort of aggressive behavior, then owners let it go. Most owners reward bad behaviors. How many hours is too many hours in a crate? 8 to 9 is pushing it. It's pushing it. Next.
With high prey drive to be okay with cats, get along with cats, and to have the cats get along with the dog.
So, well, if you've got a dog with high prey drive that's going after your dog,
after your cat,
I would put the dog into avoidance first. So I would put the dog into avoidance. So avoidance is high level correction again. If your dog is trying to kill cats, intent to harm, I would get your dog to ignore the cat. I would get your dog to ignore the cat at first. That's what I would do.
How do I calm my dog down when people come over?
Calming your dog down, what you want to do to calm your dog down is it's a lifestyle. So what you want to do is this, again, work on your duration stuff, place and down. Also, don't allow free roaming. When people come over, tell them to just leave your dogs alone. I want when people come over to be a non-event. Same with chickens. Yep. Chickens, horses, cows, livestock. Yep, same thing. High level. Because if your dog goes into a neighbor's yard and tries to kill their livestock, your neighbor has the right to shoot that dog. Yep. Oh, hey, Morgan, how are you?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, you guys did great. I put up a short video clip. Morgan, how was the sex last night when you got home? Morgan, how was it? You know what turns Morgan on? When her husband gives corrections to the dog.
Shut up.
Yeah. Which dog breeds are known to be smart? I don't know. I think all dogs are smart. I think all dogs are really smart. Not in national TV. No, Morgan, nobody watches this show. Nobody watches this show.
Mm-mm, nobody.
Your neighbor's dogs will not stop barking. I've already talked to them. Nothing changed. Any ideas? Ah, Nat, Benny. That's such a hard one. Well, we're all entitled to quiet enjoyment. So you can call up animal control. Yeah, that's a hard one. You know, I mean, you can't like spray your neighbor's dogs. Like, you just can't. So it's that's a hard one. I would talk to the neighbors. I'd call the police. I would call animal control. We all have the right to quiet enjoyment. I mean, if your dogs are out there for 5 minutes barking, whatever.
Oh, from Brett. Great hotel time.
Nice. See that? Brett, man. See? Proud of you, Brett. Proud of you, Morgan. All right? Morgan did a testimonial yesterday. She has a dog, and we rehabbed it. That's that dog, Rowdy, that you see me doing a little video with. So if you saw the video on Facebook today, there's a dog named Rowdy. I'm muzzled. He tried to attack me. I have it on camera. I asked them on camera, how has their sex life been since they've been rehabbing their dog? Big smiles from both of them. I'm telling you, better behaved dogs, owners have better sex lives. It's a fact. What's next?
How do I get my two Pomeranians to stop barking and jumping when people come to the door?
All right. We talked about this last week. Did you not take my advice?
Is it the same person?
Yep.
What? Bonkers, right?
Bonkers.
Yeah.
So get a bonker. So this is what I want you to do.
You got to make a couple of them, though. Not you, but them.
You're going to get a couple of them, okay? You can get a washcloth. Get two washcloths. Roll it up like this, all right? Put elastics like this, elastic, rubber bands, depending on where you live. And your dogs are barking at the door. You say no, toss this at the dog. Then you have a couple more ready. Boom, no, boom, no, boom. They're towels, all right? They're towels, all right? That's what you do. So I told you that last week, but you didn't do it yet. Jane? I'm holding you accountable. Jane, I remember you. I remember you. I see, Jane, I see you on Twitter. Jane, I think I've actually sent you a video. Didn't I, Jane? Didn't I?
I think so.
Jane, I sent you a video.
I remember the shirt, right?
Jane, I took the, I didn't send you a video?
I remember her shirt.
I think I sent you a thank you for being a fan video. I could have sworn I did. I could have sworn I did. So, all right, maybe not. But anyway, bonker. If anybody has a hard time with throwing a pillow, you know, well, you would have seen it already. But if not, I apologize.
And do you recommend pack walks in the city?
If you can do a pack walk. So you, I know, I see that you walk. You're in really good shape, Raquel. So you're walking. That picture of you, Raquel, with a blue shirt and the black shorts. You should be doing pack walks in the city with your company name on the back. Absolutely. Do pack walks. Do pack walks in the city. Absolutely do pack walks. Yep. Yep. Make sure you got a balanced pack, though, if you're representing. All right.
How long should my dog be able to stay, my puppy be able to stay in place when teaching duration?
How old's the puppy? Different. How old's the puppy? Mm. Oh, thanks, Jane. Oh, that's right. I think you just joined my world, Jane. But still, thank you. Jane, I love you. Thank you for being a fan. Thank you for being a fan. Hey, do people know how to take pictures? Here, let's do a screenshot. Ready? This is what I want people to do. Does everybody know how to make a screenshot on their phone? If you don't know how to make a screenshot on your phone, you hit the big button, at the bottom, the thumb button, and then you hit your on-off button at the exact same time, and it clicks.
That's 15 weeks.
Okay? What I want you to do right now is take a screenshot photo of us and then tweet it to us. So you tweet it to me at Solid Canine Training. So you go to Twitter, you write, you know, you hit letter, right? You know, write, put out a tweet at Solid Canine Training, attach a picture of us, and I will send you back a video. Okay? And I want it to say madly in love with you guys. Right? At Solid Canine Training with a photo you're about to take. Madly in love with you guys. Ready? For 10 seconds, we'll freeze here. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go. Okay, great. Awesome. Do I have a training facility in California? No, I don't. My colleague Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog does. TheGoodDog.net. TheGoodDog.net does. I got a training facility in Providence, Rhode Island, but I was just in. Shelter dog, is it going back to the shelter? If it's going back to the shelter, there's not much you can do.
I thought you had to have Twitter to do Periscope.
No, you can do your phone number. Yeah, there's not much you can do. You got to pull that dog out of the shelter and then start working it. Working a shelter dog, so you're going to struggle. Unless the shelter is going to follow through with everything you do, the dog will just fall apart.
Easy ride. He's in Los Angeles.
Yeah, it'll just fall apart. For getting a dog to become. With Raquel. No, wait till the end. Wait till the end of the show. I'm going to send you a video, Raquel.
Help. How can I train 9 6-week-old puppies?
9 6-week-old puppies? What are you, crazy? Why do you have 9 6-week-old puppies? So 6-week-old puppies, are they still nursing? Are they still nursing, or have they gone on to soft kibble? What are they doing? What are they doing? Do they still need to breastfeed?
Should I have specific cages for my two palms, or can they swap?
No, I want them each to be in their own cage each time. Right? They eat kibble. Okay. So what I want you to do is this. I want every puppy in its own kennel. I want every puppy in its own kennel. During the day, they can hang out together. At night, they're all in their own kennel. Each one of them. Boom, 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 boom. Kennel them all up. Each one of them eats in their own kennel. Got it? Food, 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 food. I want every dog to be able to go in the crate. When you open up the crate door, if the puppy tries to come out of the crate door, you close the crate door. No puppies come out of crates without permission. What I want you to do is go to my website, and do it. There's a kennel up video on my YouTube channel, a kennel up video. All right. Kennel up video. Watch that. So you're going to start doing waiting at thresholds, kenneling up, waiting for food. That's what you're going to start. All right.
How and when to use a dressage whip?
Oh, dressage whips we mostly use in socialization. Dog socialization. Joshua, I think I've got some videos on that. So we use it for dog socialization. We normally use it to just move dogs around.
R Galvin or whatever, we already answered that question.
Where was the question?
About the 15-week dog staying in place for duration.
Oh, no, I never gave her an answer.
Oh, I thought you did.
So 15 weeks. So it's thegooddog.net. Thegooddog.net. Sean O'Shea and Laura Morgan, they're my colleagues. So 15-week-old dog should be able to stay in place after the first week, probably for about 15 minutes, and then 30 minutes, and then 45 minutes, and then 1 hour. Dressage, D-R-E-S-S-A-G-E, Shaq. No massaging going on here. None. All right? Yep.
How do I get my two dachshunds to be more friendly and less aggressive with other dogs?
So they're antisocial. What I would start doing is you want to use balanced dogs first. Dogs that you know, you have to correct them for unwanted behavior. Unwanted behavior. All this dog socialization stuff, you have to go primal. Do we understand that dogs are pack animals? Okay. So I don't care. I could care. I know, Raquel, I see your questions on the Q&A. I see them all the time. Raquel, I think I might have answered one of your questions on the Q&A. I think I might have. When I was a guest host, I was just out in LA. With them. I think I might have answered one of your questions. Because I think I had to pay them $100 just to answer that question. So, because I wanted to talk to you live. Do we understand that animals, that dogs are pack animals? There is a hierarchy. All you have to do is watch dogs interact. You'll understand that there is a pack. That doesn't mean they can't be loners, but there is a pack hierarchy. I work with packs of dogs. It'd be like, don't tell me they're not pack animals. I work with packs of dogs. So we're talking about primitive genetics. We're talking about millions and millions of years of genetic makeup. When it comes to dog-dog interactions, we go back a million years ago. Oh, good. Good. Okay. We go back a million years ago. And it's called this. If you don't act appropriate, I will correct you. That's what we do. It's a really simple concept. So what do? That's why I like my dressage whips. If you start acting too aggressive, I correct you. If you act appropriate, I leave you alone. All right. What else do we got?
Nothing.
It's 10:05.
We're done.
Show's over. Did that guy ever come back?
No.
Well, maybe that guy emailed me. Maybe he emailed me. Hold on. Let me check. Maybe he emailed me. The guy that told me that I should hook up the remote collar to the hearts. Let's see if he emailed me.
My phone is so dirty.
I challenge. Sneaky SOB. What happened, Sneaky SOB? What happened to your wonderful picture? Oh, it's not showing up. Something's wrong with my. You know what it is? I got your picture right there. Something's wrong with my iPad Mini tonight. My iPad Mini. So, nope, you didn't email me. Yeah, I'm waiting for somebody to rehab a dog without an aversive. I'm waiting. I love how people, Linda, where are the kids?
I don't know.
They're inside a house. We're staying, we're parked outside somebody's home on their farm. We're on a farm tonight in Fredericksburg, Texas. Okay. I love how people love to tell me, what I'm doing is wrong and that you don't have to correct it. Come into my arena. This isn't it. It's like, literally, you're not playing in my arena. You're not working with the dogs that I work with. You're not working with the intensity, the fear, the anxiety. You're not. Maybe your personal dog, you've been able to fix a certain way. That's because you've got all the time in the world. Good for you. But with a client's dog, you're not. I know you're not. Because if you were, putting out videos. Let me tell everybody a story. We all know about the Philadelphia story. You want to go inside or you want to stay here?
How long are you going to be?
I don't know. I'll just start talking. Okay.
All right. But we got people inside.
So go ahead inside.
No, you and I have people inside.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Can I stay for
gracious enough to feed us and let us stay on their property? And you're going to stay out here while you should be inside. And you know that that's the truth.
No, she's right there. Shanna, the horse movie's on her. Shanna, can we have a couple more minutes out here? Can we have a couple more minutes? See how respectful she was? See how our hostess was watching a Periscope.
What? And I'm respectful or disrespectful?
She said that they're watching the horse movie.
But they were watching Elf.
Elf is over. See, absolutely. Do we have time for sex? I'm quick. It takes me 2 minutes. I'm 50. You know? Man, I'm out, ba-bing, ba-boom, ba-boom, I'm over. Okay. So, all right. So. I get phone calls every day from people. I get applications online from people. Somebody went to a animal behaviorist in North Carolina. Very well known. Okay? Very well known. All right? All right? So very well known. And you know what happened? They determined their dog was aggressive. Dog aggressive. Guess how they started the rehab process? With a stuffed dog. They used a stuffed dog. This is an animal behaviorist. They've got letters after their name. They've got a college degree in animal science. They might even have a master's degree. Okay? They might even have a master's degree. They started the rehabilitation of a dog who they thought was dog aggressive. After talking on the phone with this person, I told them right off the bat, their dog is not aggressive. I don't even need to see the dog to know it's not aggressive. Why? Because I rehabilitate aggressive dogs. I can ask you certain questions on the phone. I will know if that dog is aggressive or not aggressive. An animal behaviorist. Work that dog around a stuffed dog, a toy. Sorry, I don't care how smart you did on your tests. I don't care how many classes you passed. I don't care how many books you have written. I don't care who your mentor was. But when we work with aggressive dogs, do you know what we do? I use my dogs. I use four of my own personal dogs. Guess what? Why? They're dog aggressive. They're not stuffed animal aggressive. I'd like to think it's common sense. I would like to think that it's common sense. But I didn't go to college. I have no fancy degrees. All right? So I don't know what I'm talking about. I am blown away by someone that calls themselves and is titled an animal behaviorist who specializes in the behavior of animals, ever including a stuffed dog, to rehabilitate an aggressive dog. What? I mean, how do you explain that? Like, did they teach you that in school? Like, is that like, really? Where did you learn that? I mean, is that a class? I'm being serious here. Is that a class? Were you sitting in a classroom? I want you to know that this is a common practice. This is common practices. This is common practice. Are you sitting in a classroom with 30 or 40 of your classmates and your teacher is in the front doing a PowerPoint presentation and they're going through conceptual learning of dogs and the rehabilitation of dogs and they're going through the counter conditioning protocols of dogs? Okay. And I want to know, do they suggest using a stuffed dog? We all know we can buy stuffed dogs at like toy stores and like Petco. Like we know those are dog toys, right? Like do we all realize that those are actually dog toys? You know, I find it really, really interesting. So, what's about dummies? Teaching a dog to bite a human is different. Most dogs that bite are equipment trained. Has ever seen, you know, Schutzen training or the guy in the Michelin suit, the girl in the Michelin suit? That's just equipment. A lot of those dogs won't bite a human. So Uma, who's my dog that just passed recently, like 2 weeks ago. So she was equipment trained. So if you hold up your arm and I gave her the bite command, she would bite it. If you were standing next to me and she was in a down, and what I would do, and if the person shook my hand, she wouldn't move. If he raised up his hand like this to hit me, she would attack him. If he wasn't wearing the bite suit, she wouldn't do it. Why? Because she was equipment trained. Because that's all I ever wanted her to be, is equipment trained. I just wanted it to be a game for her. That's all I wanted it to do. That's all I wanted it to do. Because I carry guns. So I don't need my dog for that. So I got family pets. I protect my dogs. The problem I have with two pumps is more my guys who cuddle them. Your other people cuddle them? Don't let them. Don't let other people cuddle them. Why are you letting other people cuddle your dogs? You can get into ring sport before you tackle your own dog. You can do parallel. Don't feel like you've got a, you know, your partner cuddles them. Tell your partner to stop. That's a relationship issue. Tell your partner every time you want to cuddle the dogs, cuddle you. Cuddle. He won't? So? Tell him, go on to match.com and find someone that listens to you. Go on to match.com. I bet you there's plenty of guys on match.com that would love to date you that won't cuddle your dog. You know? So he's being disrespectful. He's being disrespectful. So, you know, relationship advice, I charge double. And I do relationship advice. So, and no, I don't think cuddling is bad at all. Absolutely not. All right. I absolutely don't think cuddling is bad, but your dogs are being disrespectful. Yep. Look at that, Morgan. Morgan, tell them the sex is better with better behaved dogs. Morgan, you're making me blush. Morgan turned so many colors of red this weekend. So funny.
I'm not on the Periscope anymore.
But you can listen to me talk. So no, cuddling dogs isn't bad at all, but you've got dogs with behavioral problems. Madly in love with you too, Raquel. I love you, honey. So you've got dogs with behavioral problems. You got dogs with behavioral problems. So you have to take stuff away right now. You've got two little entitled bratty dogs, if I can put it really simple. You know what I mean? So we got to go. We got to go. Linda's going to start yelling, and she's Italian. All right? Oh, yeah. Sex advice is free during rapid fire Q&A. Is Linda upset? No, she was just concentrating on your phone. Are you upset?
No, but I'm ready. I'm ready for you to stop.
Yeah. Yeah, she's not upset.
I'm starting to get agitated.
All right. Now. I love you. Bye. No, it's not. Happy wife, happy life, right? Kiss. Nope. She's very happy with me. But she's Italian. Okay. You don't F with an Italian woman. Ever.
When I say it's time to go in the house, it's time to go in the damn house.
Okay. I love all you. I do have to go.
I love you too, guys.
Goodbye. Okay,